Welcome to Set to Carry You Online Nursing Channel. I am Satish Rajamani. I feel very happy to meet you again with this video. Because of my family's marriage, I went to Chennai. For last 10 to 15 days, I was busy in preparation for that marriage. I could not post any new videos. I really feel sorry for you all. And I am very happy, and I want to say that most of my subscribers have greeted me on the occasion of Diwali. Also, they have greeted me by heart for the marriage functions, which I posted my photos in my WhatsApp status. I again thank you all for waiting for this video. And let's go for today's video. Before going to today's video, please subscribe to SAT to Carry Online Nursing Channel if you have not yet subscribed so far. Let's go for the first question of the day. Antibodies are produced by option A, plasma cells, B, lymphocytes, C, erythrocytes, D, basophils. Antibodies are produced by lymphocytes. The right answer is lymphocytes. Question number 2. Failure of testes to descend into the scrotum is called option A, impotency, option B, castration, option C, pedogenesis, option D, cryptorchidism. Failure of testes to descend into the scrotum is called, the right answer is cryptorchidism. Question number 3. Prothrombin is produced by option A, blood, B, liver, C, ovary, D, spleen. Prothrombin is produced by liver. Let's move on to question number 4. Serum amylase level is used to assess the damage of option A, liver, B, stomach, C, pancreas, D, intestine. Serum amylase level is used to assess the damage of pancreas. Question number 5. H2 blocker of choice in liver disease is option A, ranitidine, B, cimetidine, C, nizatidine, option D, famotidine. Which is the drug of choice of liver disease? The right answer is nizatidine is the H2 blocker of choice in liver disease. Question number 6. In the complex sense of vision, the image of an object focus on the retina and is transmitted to the brain by option A, cornea, B, iris, C, optic nerve, and D, lens. The right answer for question number 6 is optic nerve, which is responsible for transmitting the image from the retina to the brain. Question number 7. Many children with tonsillitis develop ear infection. This is because the air and the throat are connected by the option A, larynx, B, epiglottis, C, esophagus, D, eustachian tube. The right answer is eustachian tube, which connects the air and the throat. That's why the children with tonsillitis develops ear infection very easily. Question number 8. The mesoderm gives rise to all the following structures in the fully developed fetus except option A, circulatory system, B, muscular system, C, gonads, D, nervous system. The mesoderm gives rise to all the following structures in the fully developed fetus except gonads. All other organs in the circulatory system, muscular system, and nervous system all developed from the mesoderm except gonads. Question number 9. Anaphylaxis to drug is treated by option A, intravenous fluids, Option B, nebulization. Option C, oxygen administration. Option D, adrenaline injection. Anaphylaxis to the drug is treated by adrenaline injection. Is used to treat any anaphylactic reaction to a drugs. Question number 10. The danger of convulsion, a woman with preeclampsia ends. Option A, after labor begins. Option B, after delivery occurs. Option C, 24 hours postpartum period. Option D, 48 hours postpartum. The danger of convulsion in a woman with preeclampsia ends at 48 hours in postpartum period. Question number 11. Holistic care refers to option A, disease, spread, and environmental interventions, interactions. Option B, emotions of the patients. Option C, mind, body, and spread of the patient and their families. Option D, measles and neurological disorders. What do you mean by holistic care? The holistic care refers to the care given in the mind, body, spirit of the patient and their families. Question number 12. The nurse needs to dash while lifting or carrying heavy objects. Option A, keep the knees close to each other. Option B, maintain a wide base or support. Option C, bend the back perpendicular to the body. Option D, hold objects away from the body. The nurse needs to dash while lifting or carrying heavy objects. The right answer is to maintain a wide base or support when lifting or carrying a heavy objects. Question number 13. Which of the following is the best position for examining the rectum? Option A, lithotomy. Option B, SIMS position. Option C, knee chest position. Option D, left lateral position. Which of the following is the best position for examining the rectum? Knee chest position is the best position we need to give for patient while examining the rectum. And for all those who are seeing this video, I want to make a request. Just give what score you are getting out of this 100 questions in the comment box below, so that we will know how much you are having knowledge and how much you have prepared for the upcoming exams. It will be motivating you to get more mark in the next videos. Question number 14. Anticoagulant of choice for estimating blood glucose is option A, EDTA. Option B, sodium citrate. Option C, sodium fluoride. Option D, heparin. Anticoagulant of choice for estimating blood glucose is sodium fluoride. Is commonly used as an anticoagulant for estimating blood glucose. Question number 15. Frequent swallowing in a patient following tonsillectomy indicates option A, hemorrhage. Option B, thirst in patient. Option C, active gag reflex. Option D, none of the above. The frequent swallowing in patient following tonsillectomy indicates hemorrhage. Question number 16. Identify the isotonic fluid among the following. Option A, 0.9% normal saline. Option B, Ringer lactate. Option C, dextrose 5% in water. And option D, all of the above. In this 3.9% normal saline, Ringer lactate, dextrose 5% in water, which is the isotonic fluid? The right answer, all the above are the isotonic fluids. Question number 17. Paracelsus is treated with option A, DDT 5% or 10%. Option B, carbonic lotion 1:40 ratio. Option C, equal part of kerosene and equal part of oil. Option D, all the above. Pediculosis is treated with all the above said solutions. DDT 5% or 10%, carbonic lotion 1:40. Option C, that equal part of kerosene and equal part of oil. All these three things are used to treat pediculosis. Question number 18. The normal cholesterol level is option A, 100 to 150 milligram per deciliter. Option B, 150 to 200 milligram per deciliter. Option C, 200 to 250 milligram per deciliter. And option D is 250 to 300 milligram per deciliter. The normal cholesterol level is below 200 milligram per deciliter, that is 150 to 200 milligram per deciliter is considered as the normal cholesterol level according to American Heart Association. Question number 19. Most important concern while providing oral care to an unconscious client is option A, use ordered mouth care solution. B, preventing aspiration. C, look for dentures. Option D, provide oral care in each shift. Which is the most important concern while providing oral care to an unconscious client? The right answer is to prevent any aspiration of fluids while giving oral care to unconscious client is the priority nursing care. Question number 20. In an adult patient, length of incision of Goodell's airway is measured between the first incisor to the option A, angle of the mandible. Option B, nasopharynx. Option C, oropharynx. Option D, earlobe. In adult patient, the length of incision of Goodell's airway is measured between the incisor to the right answer is angle of the mandible. So we used to measure the distance of Goodell's while inserting the Goodell's airway between the first incisor to the angle of the mandible. Let's move on to question number 21. Which behavior should the nurse recognize as the motor reflex response? Option A, abduction of the arms. Option B, extension of the legs and the fanning of the toes. Option C, abduction and adduction of the arms. Option D, extension of the arms. In motor reflex, the child will elicit abduction and adduction of the arms. This is the thing the nurse must notice when expecting for a motor reflex response. Question number 22. Thyroid is effective only in the presence of option A, calcium. B, iodine. C, potassium. And D, chloride. Thyroid is effective in the presence of iodine. Question number 23. The difference between apical pulse and radial pulse rate is called the option A, rhythm deficit. Option B, heart amplitude. Option C, pulse deficit. Option D is pulse amplitude. The difference between apical pulse and radial pulse rate is known as pulse deficit. Let's move on to question number 24. The center for heart regulation is located in option A, thalamus. B, hypothalamus. C, medulla oblongata. D, cerebrum. The center for heart regulation is located in hypothalamus. Let's move on to question number 25. Aspartate aminotransferase enzyme's role is option A, processing proteins. Option B, plays a role in the metabolism, the process that converts food into energy. Option C is both A and B. Option D is none of the above. The enzyme aspartate aminotransferase role is, right answer is, processing proteins as well as plays a role in the metabolism, the process that converts food into energy. So the option C, both A and B, is the right answer here. Question number 26. Gallbladder is located in option A, upper right part of abdomen, option B, on right side of liver, option C, on left side of liver, option D, below the liver. You know very well that gallbladder is located below the liver. Question number 27. Rectus femoris is which type of muscle? Option A, fusiform, B, elongator, C, triangular, D, pinnate muscle. Rectus femoris is a type of pinnate muscle. 28. Which of the following represents the correct pathway for the conduction of an action potential through the heart? Option A, AV node, AV bundle, SA node, Purkinje fibers, and bundle of His branches. Option B, SA node, then it goes to bundle of His, then move on to bundle branches, where from there it goes to AV node and Purkinje fibers. Option C, SA node, AV node, bundle of His, bundle branches, and Purkinje fibers. Option D, AV node, bundle branches, bundle of His, SA node, and Purkinje fibers. So the right pathway for conduction of action potential through the heart. You must know the conduction system of the heart to give the right answer for this question. Conduction system of heart, the pathway from SA node, it moves to AV node. Then from there, it goes to bundle of His, and through bundle of bundle branches, it moves to Purkinje fibers to all part of the heart. Question number 29. Myopia is corrected by option A, cylindrical lens, B, convex lens, option C, concave lens, and D is bifocal lens. Myopia is corrected by using concave lens. Myopia is corrected by using concave lens. Question number 30. Torch infection includes all except. Torch infection includes all except option A, rubella, B, tetanus, C, cytomegalovirus, D, toxoplasmosis. So the T stands for toxoplasmosis, not the tetanus. The right answer is B, tetanus is exception in the torch infection. Question number 31. Coronary arteries primarily receives blood supply during option A, inspiration, B, diastole, C, expiration, D, systole. Coronary arteries primarily receives blood supply during diastole. When the heart muscles relax, the coronary artery receives the blood supply for the drainage. Question number 32. A client becomes unconsciousness and unresponsive to the stimuli. Next action is to option A, activate the resuscitation team, option B, inform the physician, option C, give adrenaline, option D, perform suction. When a client becomes unconsciousness and unresponsive to the stimuli, the immediate action the nurse must do is to activate the resuscitation team. Let's move on to question number 33. Risk factor for development of deep vein thrombosis is option A, oral contraceptive pills, option B, hypertension, option C, myocardial infarction, option D, none of the above. For developing deep vein thrombosis, the risk factor is using oral contraceptive pills, hypertension, and myocardial infarction. All these three are the risk factor for development of deep vein thrombosis. Question number 34. Cause behind cardiac wall disorders includes all except option A, rheumatic fever, B, infection, endocarditis, option C, connective tissue abnormalities, option D, congestive heart failure. Which is the cause behind cardiac wall disorder except? The right answer is congestive heart failure is not the cause for cardiac wall disorder. Question number 35. Hemolytic disease of newborn is diagnosed with? Option A, aminocentesis. Option B, direct Coombs test. Option C, indirect Coombs test. Option D is plasmapheresis. Hemolytic disease of the newborn is diagnosed with? The right answer is direct Coombs test is used to diagnose hemolytic disease in a newborn baby. Question number 36. Persistently elevated blood pressure with an unknown cause is known as? Option A, stage 1 hypertension. B, malignant hypertension. C, primary hypertension. And D is chronic hypertension. Persistently elevated blood pressure with unknown causes known as primary hypertension. Question number 37. Nitroglycerin belongs to dash group of drugs. Nitroglycerin belongs to dash group of drugs. Option A, vasodilator. B, beta blocker. C, calcium channel blocker. And D is ACE inhibitors. Nitroglycerin belongs to vasodilators. You know very well, vasodilator, the best example is nitroglycerin. Question number 38. Capillary refill time is normally? Option A, between 1 to 6 seconds. B, between 1 to 3 seconds. Option C is 2 to 5 seconds. And option D is less than 10 seconds. The capillary refill time normal is between 1 to 3 seconds. Question number 39. Emergency treatment of hypovolemic shock include? Option A, relief of pain. Option B, administration of vasodilators. Option D, administration of IV fluids or blood products. Option D is antibiotic administration. Which is the emergency treatment of hypovolemic shock? The right answer is option C, administration of IV fluids or blood products. Question number 40. Identify the correct statement regarding acute respiratory distress syndrome. The correct statement regarding acute respiratory distress syndrome. Option A, alveoli are overexpanded. Option B, alveoli lost elasticity. Option C, alveoli spaces are filled with fluids. Option D, alveoli are collapsed. The right answer for this is alveoli spaces are filled with fluids. So in case of acute respiratory distress syndrome, the alveoli spaces are filled with fluids. Option C is the right answer. Question number 41. The antihelminthic drug given for hookworm infection is? Option A, albendazole. Option B, metronidazole. Option C is mebendazole. Option D is both A and C. Antihelminthic drug given for hookworm infection is albendazole and mebendazole. Option D, both A and C is the right answer. 42. During pregnancy, fundal height reaches safest sternum at option 10 weeks, B, 36 weeks. Option C, 34 weeks. Option D, 32 weeks. During pregnancy, fundal height reaches safest sternum at 36 weeks. Question number 43. The common cause of parotitis among children is? Option A, mumps. B, rubella. C, chickenpox. D, measles. The common cause of parotitis among children, the right answer is mumps. Mumps is the major cause of parotitis among children. Question number 44. The main muscle of inspiration is? Option A, salinus anterior. Option B, diaphragm. Option D, rectus abdominis. Option D, internal intercostalis. Which is the main muscle for inspiration? The diaphragm is the main muscle for inspiration process. Option B is the right answer for question number 44. 45. ORS, oral rehydration solution, mainly contains? Option A, calcium and glucose. Option B, sodium and fructose. Option C is sodium and glucose. Option D is calcium and fructose. The ORS mainly contains sodium and glucose is the right answer. Question number 46. OSHA worker is posted in all given below except option A, super specialty hospital, option B, community health centers, option C is field visits, option D is sub center. OSHA workers are posted in community centers, field visits and sub center except super specialty hospitals. Question number 47. Hydromnios is a condition where there is excess volume of option A, peritoneal fluid, B, pericardial fluid, C, pleural fluid and D, amniotic fluid. Hydromnios is a condition in which there will be excess volume of amniotic fluid. Question number 48. The corpus luteum of pregnancy is functionally active up to option A, 2 to 4 weeks, option B, 6 to 8 weeks, option C is 4 to 6 weeks and option D is 10 to 12 weeks. The corpus luteum of pregnancy is functionally active up to 10 to 12 week period. Question number 49. Bunis test is used to confirm option A, neurogenic incontinence, option B, overflow incontinence, option C, stress incontinence, option D, urge incontinence. Bunis test is used to confirm. The right answer is stress incontinence. At the time of stress incontinence, to diagnose it, Bunis test is used. Question number 50. In a healthy woman, the only organism found in upper 2/3 of the vagina is option A, trichomoniasis, option B, Dodderlin's bacillus, option C, moniliasis, option D, syphilis. In a healthy woman, the only organism found in upper 2/3 of the vagina is, the right answer is Dodderlin bacillus. Option B is the right answer for question number 50. Let's move on to question number 51. All of the following are the neurotransmitters except option A, dopamine, B, GABA, C, troponin and D is serotonin. Which is not the neurotransmitter? Dopamine is a neurotransmitter, GABA is a neurotransmitter, serotonin is neurotransmitter, troponin is a biological marker, it is a protein which we use to diagnose the myocardial infarction. It's a biological marker. Option C is the right answer for question number 51. Let's move on to question number 52. A patient has brought to the emergency department after a head injury. The nurse noticed that there is a clear drainage from the nose. Which of the following test is useful and most reliable to determine if the drainage is a cerebrospinal fluid, CSF? Option A, pH test, option B, test for glucose, option C, test for beta 2 transferrin, option D is test for chloride. So which test is used to determine the presence of CSF in a client brought to emergency department after head injury? The right answer is conduct a test for a beta 2 transferrin, which tells that the fluid is a CSF or a normal fluid. Question number 53. Sixth cranial nerve, abducens nerve, controls option A, movement of the eyeball, option B, taste perception, option C, closure of epiglottis, option D, movement of tongue. The sixth cranial nerve mainly controls the movement of the eyeball. So option A is the right answer. Question number 54. In regional anesthesia patient, option A, becomes unconscious rapidly, option B, is unconscious, option C, is able to recognize pain, option D, is having long term effects of anesthesia. The right answer is option B, is conscious. Question number 55. Which of the following is not advised for the patient with pruritus? Option A, daily baths with scented soaps. Option B, wearing clothes made up of 100% cotton. Option C, increasing fluid intake. Option D, all of the above. Which of the following is not advised for the patient with pruritus? The right answer is daily baths with scented soap is not advised for the patient with pruritus. Repeated itching. Question number 56. T wave inversion on the ECG are seen in the following conditions except option A, hyperkalemia. Option B, myocardial infarction. Option C, myocarditis. Option D, subarachnoid hemorrhage. T wave inversion on the ECG are seen in the following conditions except hyperkalemia. Whereas in hyperkalemia, there will be elevation of T wave. Other conditions like myocardial infarction, myocarditis, and subarachnoid hemorrhage, we can see that there will be the inversion of T wave. Question number 57. The best indicator of adequate fluid balance in a client with burns, especially in the first 48 hours of care, is option A, change in level of consciousness. Option B, elevated hematocrit levels. Option B, urine output 30 to 50 ml per hour. Option D is weight of the patient. Which is the best indicator of adequate fluid balance in a client with burn, especially in the first 48 hours of the care? So usually the urine output should be assessed. If it is between 30 to 50 ml per hour, that is the best indicator for the client affected with burn in the first 48 hours of care. Question number 58. Release of which of the following chemical causes pain at injury site? Release of which of the following chemical causes pain at injury site? Option A, prostaglandins. Option B, serotonin. Option C, norepinephrine. Option D, endorphins. Option A, prostaglandin is the right answer. This releases once there is any injury, and because of that there is any pain, due to that the prostaglandins will be released in the body. Question number 59. Which of the following drug is an example for synthetic opioid analgesic? Option A, aspirin. Option B, morphine. Option C, indomethacine. Option D, fentanyl. Which of the following drug is an example for synthetic opioid analgesic? The right answer is fentanyl is the best example for synthetic opioid analgesic. Question number 60. Ototoxicity is common side effect of the drug streptomycin. This is due to the damage to option A, 4th cranial nerve. Option B, 8th cranial nerve. Option C, 7th cranial nerve. And D is 10th cranial nerve. Ototoxicity is common side effect of the drug streptomycin. This is due to the damage to the 8th cranial nerve, vestibulocochlear nerve. Question number 61. The germ theory of disease was propounded by option A, Robert Koch. Option B, Hippocrates. Option C, Louis Pasteur. Option D, August Weismann. The germ theory was propounded by Louis Pasteur. The right answer is Louis Pasteur. Question number 62. Which of the following mission must be emphasized to strengthen the healthcare system in the country? Option A, increasing opportunity to be healthy. Option B, financing national healthcare program. Option C, let people manage their own health. Option D, supporting environment for healthy habits. Which of the following mission must be emphasized to strengthen the healthcare system in the country? The right answer is option C, Let people manage their own health is the right answer. Question number 63. In simmering, the food is prepared at option A at boiling point, option B above boiling point, option C below boiling point, and D in normal water. In simmering process, the food is prepared below boiling point. Question number 64. Congenital rubella is diagnosed in infant with the help of antibodies in infant. Option A, immunoglobulin M. Option B, immunoglobulin G. Option C, IgE. Option D, IgA. Congenital rubella is diagnosed in infant with the help of the presence of IgM antibodies in infant. Question number 65. The scientific name of ashwagandha is option A, Bithanine somnifera. Option B, Aspergus racemosus. Option D, Woodfordin fruticosa. Option D, Adadora basica. The scientific name of ashwagandha is Bithania somnifera. Question number 66. Biological product alpha 1 antitrypsin is used for the treatment of which of the following disease? Option A, cancer. Option B, emphysema. Option C, cystic fibrosis. Option D, phenylketonuria. Biological product alpha 1 antitrypsin is used for the treatment of which of the following disease? The right answer here is emphysema. In diagnosing emphysema, we should look for the presence of alpha 1 antitrypsin, which is used for the treatment, not for diagnosis, is used for the treatment of emphysema, alpha 1 antitrypsin. Question number 67. The most common psychiatric disorder after head injury is option A, mania, B, depression, C, schizophrenia, and D is phobia. The most common disorder, psychiatric disorder after head injury is mania. Question number 68. Which of the following surgery leads to dumping syndrome? Option A, appendectomy. Option B, gastrectomy. Option C, sigmoidectomy. Option D, cholecystectomy. Which of the following surgery leads to dumping syndrome? The right answer is gastrectomy. Question number 69. Most frequent neurotic disorder in puerperium is option A, postpartum blues. B, postpartum depression. C, postpartum psychosis. And D is delivery related stress and anxiety. The most frequent neurotic disorder in puerperium is, the right answer is, delivery related stress and anxiety. Postpartum depression is a psychotic disorder in puerperium. The right answer is delivery related stress and anxiety. This is the most frequent neurotic disorder in the puerperium. Note down, postpartum depression is not the right answer. The right answer is delivery related stress and anxiety is the right answer for 69th question. Option D is the right answer. Question number 70. The extrapyramidal side effects of antipsychotic drugs are managed with the following group of drugs except option A, dopamine drugs. Option B, anticholinergics. Option C is antihistamine. Option D is barbiturates. The extrapyramidal side effects of antipsychotic drugs are managed with following group of drugs except option A. The right answer is barbiturate. Barbiturate is not used for the treatment of extrapyramidal side effects. next move on to question number 71. Ponderal index of term gestational age. Normal neonate, yes. Option A, more than 2.5. Option B, less than 2.5. Option C, 2. Option D is less than 2. Ponderal index of term gestational age normal neonate is less than 2.5. Option B is the right answer. Question number 72. Management of scrotal edema following penile implant is option A, cold application. B, Trendelenburg position. Option C, maintain strict intake output chart and report to physician. Option D is elevate the scrotum using a soft support. Which is the management of scrotal edema following penile implant? The right answer is to elevate the scrotum using soft support. Question number 73. Complications related to the cataract extraction include option A, secondary glaucoma. Option B, infection. Option C, bleeding. Option D, all the above. The complications related to cataract extraction include, the right answer is all the above, which includes secondary glaucoma, infection and bleeding. All these three are the complications which occur due to the cataract extraction. Question number 74. Test used to compare the bilateral hearing of a client is called option A, Allen's test. Option B, Weber's test. Option C, Rennes test. Option D is Romberg's test. The test which is used to compare the bilateral hearing of a client is called as Weber's test. Is used to compare the bilateral hearing of a client. Question number 75. Most common cause of blindness in India is option A, cataract. Option B, glaucoma. Option C, retinal detachment. Option D is nutritional deficiency. Which is the most common cause of blindness in India? The right answer is cataract. Cataract is the most common cause of blindness in India. Question number 76 to 86 was prepared by Ms. Kanta Yadav from District Rewari, Haryana. She is a staff nurse in Kendriya Vidyalaya Nursing Manasar Gurugram, Haryana. Thank you, ma'am, for giving this 10 questions for our subscribers. Question number 76. Which antibiotic caused discoloration of teeth? Option A, streptomycin. Option B, penicillin. Option C, tetracycline. Option D, ciprofloxacin. Which antibiotic caused discoloration of teeth? It is common in use of tetracycline antibiotic, which leads to yellowish discoloration of the teeth and gums. Question number 77. India newborn action plan was launched in option A, September 2016. Option B, September 2014. Option C, September 2017. Option D, September 2018. India Newborn Action Plan was launched in, this is the logo for India Newborn Action Plan, and it was launched in the year September 2014. Question number 78. Which of the following test of infertility determines the blockage of the fallopian tubes? Option A, Hoehner's test. Option B, postcoital test. Option C, Rubin's test. Option D, none of the above. Which of the following test of infertility determines the blockage of the fallopian tubes? The right answer is Rubin's test. Rubin's test is used to diagnose the blockage of the fallopian tubes in infertility condition. Question number 79. A child whose weight is 3 kg at birth would be expected to weight how many kilogram at 1 year? Option A, 14 kilogram. B, 9 kilogram. C, same as birth weight, 3 kilogram. Option D is 6 kilogram. A child whose weight at 3 kilogram at birth will be triple in 1 year. So the right answer is 9 kg. Question number 80. Swan glands catheter PSC will be inserted to provide information about option A cardiac output, option B left ventricular functioning, option C venous pressure, option D stroke volume. Swan glands catheter will be inserted to provide information about. The right answer is left ventricular functioning. Question number 81. Hepatic encephalopathy develops when the blood level of which substance increases? Option A ammonia, B calcium, C amylase, D potassium. Hepatic encephalopathy develops when the blood level of ammonia increases. Option A is the right answer. Now we move on to question number 82. Which type of oral contraceptive pills is most appropriate for mothers who are breastfeeding? Which type of oral contraceptive pills is most appropriate for mothers who are breastfeeding? Option A estrogen only, B progesterone only, C mixed type estrogen and progesterone, option D is 21 day pills mixed type. The right answer here is progesterone only is the most effective oral contraceptive pills in mothers who is breastfeeding. Question number 83. A 2-year-old child is admitted for traction to treat congenital hip dislocation. The nurse anticipates using which traction system? Option A Brands traction, option C Bucks extension, option C is Halo traction, option D is all the above. When a 2-year-old child is admitted for a traction to treat congenital hip dislocation, the nurse anticipates using the Brands traction system. Question number 84. A client is diagnosed with schizotypal personality disorder. Which sign would this client exhibit during social situation? A client diagnosed with schizotypal personality disorder, which sign would the client exhibit during social situation? Like option A aggressive behavior, B emotional affect, C independence need, option D is paranoid thought. In schizotypal, the sign to be noticed paranoid thinking. Question number 85. Which of possible complication with rubella German measles to a pregnant woman? Which of possible complication with rubella German measles to a pregnant woman? Option A severe preeclampsia, option B fetal abnormalities, option C hydatid form mole formation, option D is premature labor. The right answer here is fetal abnormalities. Question number 686. Which assessment finding best indicates the presence of chlamydia in pregnant women? Option A painful blister on the labia, option B heavy grayish white discharge, option C thick white vaginal discharge, option D all the above. The assessment finding best indicates the presence of chlamydia in pregnant women is heavy grayish white tish discharge from vagina. Question number 87. Which of the following are sign of ovulation? Option A spina bulkit, option B metal skimmers, option C thin watery cervical mucus, option D all the above. Which of the following are the sign of ovulation? The right answer is spina bulkit, metal skimmers, thin watery cervical mucus. All the three things are the sign of ovulation. Question number 88. National nutritional policy functions under the department. Option A Department of Women and Child Development, option B Department of Health and Family Welfare, option C Home Affairs, option D all the above. National nutritional policy functions under the department. The right answer is Department of Women and Child Development. This is the answer for question number 88. Now we move on to question number 89. Most common site of extrathoracic tuberculosis in children. Option A, lymph node. B, skeleton. C, central nervous system. And D is heart. The most common site of extrathoracic tuberculosis in children. The right answer is lymph node. Question number 90. The function of an adjuvant in a vaccine is to enhance its option A, distribution. B, immunogenicity. Option C is absorption. Option D, shelf life. The function of adjuvant in vaccine is to enhance the shelf life. Question number 91. Best way of sterilizing disposable plastic syringes is option A, UV rays. Option B, gamma rays. Option C, autoclave. Option D, hot air movement. Which is the best way of sterilizing disposable plastic syringes? Option B, gamma rays is the right answer. Question number 92. Majority of melanomas are caused by option A, exposure to ultraviolet ray. Option B, excess fatty tissues. Option C is lack of exposure to sunlight. Option D is lack of vitamin D. Majority of melanoma are caused by exposure to ultraviolet rays. Option A is the right answer. Question number 93. The strongest ligament of the body is option A, iliofemoral ligament. Option B is lacunar ligament. Option C is ligamentum clavum. Option B is inguinal ligament. The strongest ligament of the body is iliofemoral ligament. Question number 94. The tendency to overrate employees' performance is known as option A, halo effect. Option B is positive effect. Option C is Hawthorne effect. Option D is biasness. The tendency to overrate employees' performance is known as halo effect. Question number 95. The dose in milligram of norgestrol and ethinyl estradiol in Malayan is option A, 0.3 and 0.03. Option B, 0.8 and 0.003. Option C, 3.5 and 3.0. Option D, 3.0 and 3.0. The dose in milligram of norgestrol and ethinyl estradiol in Malayan is option A, 0.3 and 0.003. The right answer. Question number 96. What will be the attitude of head during face and brow presentation? What will be the attitude of head during face and brow presentation? Option A, flexion. B, complete extension. C, adduction. D, abduction. What will be the attitude of the head during face and brow presentation? The right answer here is complete extension. The right answer is complete extension. Question number 97. Mechanism behind physiological anemia in pregnancy is option A, increased blood volume. Option B, increased blood loss during delivery. Option C, decreased erythropoiesis. Option D, increased hemolysis. The mechanism behind physiological anemia in pregnancy. The right answer is, it is due to increased blood volume. Question number 98. Patient complains that someone is making conspiracy about me. Which type of delusion is it? Option A, delusion of infidelity. Option B, delusion of nihilism. Option C, delusion of persecution. Option D is delusion of grandiosity. When the patient complains that someone is making conspiracy about them, then it belongs to the type of delusion of persecution. The right answer. Question number 99. Decreased bone density is called option A, osteoporosis. B, osteomalacia. C, osteoarthritis. And option D, rheumatoid arthritis. The decreased bone density is called as osteoporosis. The right answer is osteoporosis. Question number 100. While caring for terminally ill cancer patient, the priority nursing intervention is option A, to reduce pain. Option B is maintain a patent airway. Option C is administer oxygen. Option D is restrain the patient. While caring for terminally ill cancer patient, the priority nursing intervention is to maintain a patent airway. So here we come to end of the 100 question in the part 1 video. Part 2 video is coming soon. Stay with Satu Carry Online Nursing channel. To join the WhatsApp group, send request with your name and place to the number 90507-24820. You will be adding in I am Indian Nurse group. Also, those who are coming from South India, those who don't know Hindi, can join in this group, South Indian AIIMS Learners. Please send request with your name and place to 90507-24820. In tomorrow, we will see the next video, which contains another 100 question, continuity of this video. Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to Satu Carry Online Nursing channel if you have not yet subscribed. Thank you all again. Meet you soon. Bye-bye.